Health officials say an Omicron case detected in Queensland is the first of its kind in the world. International scientists have been alerted as the state prepares to swing open borders to hotspots.
There's a new twist to the Omicron strain discovered in a COVID patient at Prince Charles Hospital.
Today we are standing here announcing a new version of Omicron, and it's a first in the world.
A man recently travelled to Queensland from South Africa. The Delta variant was ruled out. Then international scientists from the World Health Organization were called in to help. Overnight, he was diagnosed with the new type of Omicron called Omicron-like.
It's got enough to be able to classify it as Omicron, but we don't know enough about it as to what that means then as far as clinical severity, vaccine effectiveness.
It's one of two new Omicron cases after a man in his 20s from Nigeria tested positive in Cairns. He arrived on Jetstar flight JQ950 from Sydney on Friday morning. Aircrew and passengers on that plane are now close contacts, but they were already bound for quarantine. Hospital capacity issues mean the COVID patient will be moved from Cairns to Townsville.
Cairns ICU is always a struggle. Remember, it also serves a large population in the Cape.
Well, this is the first major test and it's looking a little shaky.
Authorities insist hospitals are well prepared to cope with the influx of COVID once the borders reopen on Monday. But smaller hospitals are expected to be put to the test.
It's part of the ongoing development and we're doing that and working with all our hospitals to make sure all our hospitals are able to receive COVID cases.
Omicron's also landed in Victoria for the first time. In Sydney, the tally's now at 34 cases, after two people who attended a boat party in the harbour tested positive.
We are concerned that this could be a transmission event associated with the Omicron variant.
New South Wales has recorded more than 400 COVID cases in the past 24 hours, the biggest daily spike in 2 months, 4 days before they're allowed back into Queensland.
Marlena Wobb joins us now. Marlena, there's been an update on the border rules.
Yes, Sharon, after some confusion, the acting chief health officer says all children, including babies, will need a test before travelling to Queensland from a hotspot. Yesterday it was confirmed children more than a year old will need a PCR test. Today, Dr. Peter Aitken said babies younger than 12 months will still need a test, but it can just be a saliva test.
All right, Marlena, thank you.